science explorers, it's Justin again. We're on the lookout for the big cats of the savannah, the feline predators of these grasslands. But I'm not seeing anything right now. It seems like these cats are always hiding or running after something. So today, we'll take a look at three big cats of the savannah and figure out their secret weapons to dominate the grasslands. That is, if we can find them. Mia and I scanned the savannah in our safari vehicle and found a group of lions. We'll keep our distance while we take a look. Lions live in a pride. That's a group of lions that acts like a family. They hunt together, share food, and care for each other's young. I noticed these lions have huge teeth and claws. I wouldn't want to get too close to these. Why do you think they need to be so big and pointy? I remember that big cats are carnivores, or animals that eat mostly meat. They use their teeth and strong jaws to grab onto their prey and tear their food. And like most cats, lions have retractable claws that move in and out of their paws for a strong grip. Lions hunt as a team to take down the biggest meals they can find and keep their pride fed. What huge herbivores have we seen so far that could become their dinner? Wildebeests and zebras are some of the most popular prey for lions. But we know these herbivores migrate, and sometimes the big cats are forced to eat whatever smaller animals are still around. This pride isn't very active right now. In fact, most of them are asleep. They must be nocturnal, or mainly active at night. How do you think they sleep when it's so bright out? Huh, do you think that bright sun might be why they're sleeping? It can get really hot under the savanna sun during the day, and chasing prey under the sun can be exhausting. So they don't hunt until it gets dark and the temperature cools down. These lions seem to blend into the grass and dirt around them. I wonder why big predators like these would need to hide. A big, tough carnivore shouldn't need to hide from an animal that's scared of them, right? Ooh, look in the trees here. There's another big cat. If it's climbing a tree and covered in spots, it must be a leopard. I don't see any other leopards nearby. They must not live in big families like lions do. But like lions, leopards are also nocturnal. They have excellent night vision and carry their prey back up to the trees to have dinner all to themselves. Do you think they could carry a whole zebra up there? No, leopards try to hunt for smaller prey, like birds, monkeys, and other small mammals. The golden color and black spots on this leopard's fur are a lot different from the lion's dusty brown color. What do you think all of these different fur colors and patterns are for? Mia says these cats are using camouflage. It's how animals blend into their surroundings to hide from other living things. How do the patterns on each of these cats help them blend into their environment? They live in the same biome, right? So why do they camouflage so differently? We saw how lions tend to stay low to the ground. I wonder if the leopard's pattern has something to do with how much time they spend in the trees. Yeah, look how they disappear underneath the leaves. Their fur pattern mimics the light and shadows of the tree leaves, and the lion's light brown fur blends into the dry dirt and grass around them. Oh, finally, this cheetah has slowed down long enough for us to get a glimpse. They seem to be loners too, but we might catch them with a sibling or their cubs. The pattern on its fur looks a lot like the leopard's spots. Can you spot the difference between them? The cheetah's spots are smaller. These cats spend most of their time in the grass, and the smaller spots mimic the light and shadows seen there. But why do these cats need to hide? They're the top predators in the savannah, right? So what are they hiding from? Take a moment to pause and predict why cheetahs, lions, and leopards might be using camouflage. Ooh, do you see that? It's a gazelle grazing in the savannah. It looks like this cheetah is blending into the grass to sneak up on it. Once it starts moving, the cheetah's outline disappears, and its spots look like shadows in the grass. The gazelle won't notice that it's being stalked by a predator, giving the cheetah a head start to catch its dinner.
Check out these markings under its eyes.
Do you think this pattern is for camouflage too, or something else? This cheetah has been quite active during the day, so it must not be nocturnal like leopards and lions. It's really bright under the savannah sun. Maybe these markings can help them see? Mia says they remind her of the markings that baseball players put under their eyes. The dark marks absorb the sunlight so the athletes can see more clearly. It must work the same way for cheetahs. Since they're out hunting during the day, cheetahs need to be able to see their prey through the glaring rays of the sun. And they're off! Cheetahs are the fastest land animals on Earth. They can run up to 70 miles per hour. Their lean and long bodies are built for running. They chase fast and small prey, like gazelles and antelope, that other big cats can't keep up with. I wonder if something else helps them run with such speed and precision, like a running shoe. Mia, can you get a close-up of a cheetah's paws? It looks like this cheetah's claws are sticking out. Don't other big cats have retractable claws? Oh, Mia says cheetah's claws are semi-retractable. That means their sharp nails are always slightly exposed. Just like how soccer and baseball players wear cleats to enhance their running, cheetah claws grip the ground for improved speed and accuracy. It seems like big cats have a lot in common with athletes. They're strong and fast with unique abilities to win at their game of catching a meal. While these cats are big, they're still not the biggest mammals in the savannah. These sprawling grasslands are home to the tallest and heaviest animals on land. And I think one of them is responsible for that trumpet we keep hearing. I think we should follow it and find out. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey, hey.